The year is 1993. South Africa was on the eve of a remarkable negotiated settlement. One area was clinging steadfastly to the old order, Lukas Mangope's homeland of Bophuthatswana. The people of the homeland mobilized for their freedom, but Mangope's security forces did not let go easily. At the Truth Commission's human rights violations hearing in Northwest Province this past week, Solly Bokaba, a student leader at the time, told about the savage attack on him by former BOP policemen.
As students, as the entire community, we should take law into our own hands and run that Batista.
Yeah. You see, we should not be fooled by some few dissenters. For what, our democratized college of education, for what?
The refusal by the former homeland state Bophuthatswana, under the leadership of Lukas Mangope, to be reincorporated into the new South Africa, led to the 1993 student mobilizations to pressurize the Bophuthatswana government to hand over their power and join the negotiation process at the time. Solly Bokaba was the leader of the South African Student Congress, which was instrumental in forcing the Bophuthatswana government to reconsider its position.
For me as a patriot in this country, I need not think through my blood. I must think with my head. At that stage, the struggle for liberation of this country called me, and I knew that I might traverse in one of the horrendous ways, and this is one of the things which I had expected. So as a freedom fighter, somebody who was fighting for a country to ensure that we are liberated, and I can't at this stage be a bitter man. I might be hurt, but I should not be bitter, because once I become bitter, I'm going to be emotional and I'm going to resent. I need these people who did these things to come and reconcile with them and to ensure that we move forward.
This past week, the Truth and Reconciliation Commission's Amnesty Committee heard how Bokaba's student organization and other tertiary institutions in the Northwest joined forces to protest against the legacy of Bantustans.
During 1993, I was the president of the Student Representative Council of UNIBO, now it's called University of Northwest. I was also a member of South African Student Congress. Towards the end of January 1993, after we realized together with the student leadership in South African Student Congress, we decided that we should organize students in the whole of Bophuthatswana region, from Tabanchu to Marapsani, Madikwe, including even Mabatu area in Lihurutse. Bophuthatswana on its own, headed by Mr. Lukas Mangope, was a corruption. It was a corruption between the illegitimate, imposed, self-imposed leaders on our people, proclaiming to be legitimate Tswana leaders, with the Nationalist Party government.
By mid-1992, Solly had become a notorious figure in the Bophuthatswana homeland. He was labeled as an ANC import into the homeland with a mission of disruption and chaos.
Because of my history, I joined the ANC immediately when it was unbanned in 1990. I was the chairperson of the ANC in Itsoseng, in the Ditsobotla district. And when I went to UNIBO, it was very clear that the security police knew about me. And immediately when I assumed or I was elected as the president of the SRC, there was a clear campaign to demonize and create me as a perverse by both the politicians and the media in Bophuthatswana.
On the 7th of this month, exactly 4 years after the Bophuthatswana security police had acted on their threats, The TRC Amnesty Committee in Rustenburg, headhouse Soli Bukaba, was brutally assaulted by a group of 15 policemen.
As I was now moving towards the main gate, when I turned and see what was happening behind me, I saw these policemen running towards me. And as they were running towards me, I was still having my loud hailer. And as they were approaching me, the first one who managed to arrive me shouted an expletive like, "Otonye like a jail." Then as he said that, he then take out his baton, and these other ones were following me, he started lashing me on my head.
For Bukaba, the perpetrators are people he knew and who had constantly threatened him about his life. And ironically, when their homeland shrine, which they were preserving, has shattered, they still have not approached him and asked for forgiveness.
I feel that it's for me to ensure that I reconcile, but they also have to come to me and reconcile.